الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله
لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله الحمد لله فاطر الوجود من العدم وجاعل النور من الظلم ومخرج الصبر من الألم وملقي التوبة على الندم فنشكره على المصائب كما نشكره على النعم ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الأكرم ذو الشرف الأشم والنور الأتم والكتاب المحكم خير ولد آدم الذي بشر به عيسى بن مريم ودعا لبعثته إبراهيم عليه السلام حين يرفع قواعد بيت الله المحرم فنصلي ونسلم ونبارك على سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم إن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد بن عبد الله وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله وحسن عبادته All praise is due to Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. And peace and blessings be upon his last and final messenger. He who Allah guides will never be misguided, and he who Allah misguides will never be guided. We begin today's khutbah with Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu. He reminds us of a hadith. He says, يَتَّبِعُ الْمَيِّتُ ثَلَاثُ أَهْلَهُ وَمَالَهُ وَعَمَلُهُ فَيَرْجَعُ اثْنَانُ وَيَبْقَى وَاحِدُ يَرْجُعُ أَهْلُهُ وَمَالُهُ وَيَبْقَى عَمَلُهُ When all of us, when the day comes and we pass, and we are on our way to the grave, what follows us is our family and our wealth and our actions. Two things return, and one thing stays. Your family and your wealth go, and the actions is the only thing that stays with you in the grave. And as Ibn Malik, he commented on a different hadith. He says, "Al-akhillau thalath." Your companions in your life are three companions. Throughout your entire life, from the day you are born until the day you are die, you have three companions in your life. He says, فَأَمَّا خَلِيلَكَ الْأَوَّلِ فَيَقُولُ مَا أَعْطَيْتُكَ فَهُوَ لَكَ. Whatever you have spent on yourself, that is yours. وَمَا أَمْسَكْتُ فَلَيْسَ لَكَ فَذَلِكَ مَالُكَ. And whatever you don't save, the things that you have, your savings, things that you leave for your children, you think they are yours, but they will be for your inheritors after you have passed. And he continues and he says, وَإِنَّ مَعَكَ حَتَّى تَأْتِي بَابُ الْمُلْكِ. The second companion says, we will be with you until you get to the door of your grave. We will spend our entire lives with you, the good and the bad. But the second you pass away, we leave you in the grave and we go. And the third, he says, ثُمَّ يَرْجِعُونَ فَيَكُونُ وَمَا خَلِيلُكَ فَيَقُولُ أَنَا مَعَكُ وَحَيْثُ حَيْثُ دُخَلْتُ وَحَيْثُ خَرَجْتُ فَذَلِكَ عَمَلُكَ. The third companion is your actions. He says, no matter where you go, no matter what you do, I will be with you. But the crux of the hadith is in the last part. فَيَقُولُ وَاللَّهِ لَقَدْ كُنْتُ مِنْ أَهْوَلِ الثَّلَاثُ عَلَيْهِ. وَاللَّهِ the عَمَلِ the actions were the least important in my life. I took care of my wealth. I took care of my family. And I never thought about my actions. I never thought about what I said and what I did. I never thought about the time that passed. How did I take advantage of that time? What did I do with what I was given? And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us. He says, وَقُلْ اِعْمَلُوا فَسَيَرَى اللَّهُ عَمَلَكُمْ وَرَسُولُهُ وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanding us, saying, act. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will see your actions. And so will the Prophet, and so will the believers. Why did I begin my khutbah in this fashion? As many of us are aware, this is the last Friday of the month of Ramadan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been ever so generous to allow us to stay until this point. Many of our brothers and sisters that joined us at the beginning of Ramadan are no longer with us. And many brothers and sisters that wanted to join us never got to see the month to begin with. And like we said at the beginning of the month, right before the first khutbah of the month, Ramadan will go by quickly. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَةً. A limited number of days. The scholars have said one narration of ayyamun ma'dudat is because we count them. Nu'iddu al-yawm, we count the day. Today is the 26th day and the 27th night. The question becomes, how have we done? Have we taken advantage of our time? Have we realized the generosity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us and used that generosity to the best of our abilities? Or have we wasted it? Have we let it slip between our fingers? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he calls this month Shahr Mubarak, the most blessed of months, because of the amount of opportunities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us for repentance and for forgiveness. How do you think you did? The question is going to be individual. You have to sit and assess yourself how I did in this month. Because who knows if you will make it to the next Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, reminding us to take advantage of time and take advantage of our righteous deeds. He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُلْهِكُمْ أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُكُمْ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. Talking to the believers, he's saying, O you who believe, do not allow your wealth and your family to take you away from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whoever does so, whoever allows their family and their wealth to take them away from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, truly they are the ones that have failed. So now we have to assess. And realize that alhamdulillah, as long as we are still breathing, there is still hope. How are we going to take advantage of the last 4 days of Ramadan? And many of us seem to have a tendency. We believe because the 27th night is Laylatul Qadr, today is the last night we show up to the masjid. Not remembering that Ramadan does not end until Tuesday at Asr. And we have to take advantage of every moment until then. Not because that is, not only because that is the right thing to do, because that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to do. He says, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٌ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. He says, race to your Lord. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ, to the forgiveness of your Lord. And a jannah, the size of the heavens and the earth, prepared for those who are muttaqeen. And it's beautiful because we see the word muttaqeen, the root word of taqwa. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about taqwa when talking about siyam. He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامَ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So Allah says there, here is tattaqoon and there muttaqeen. How do we bring them together? We fast so that we can attain God consciousness. But once we have attained God consciousness, we become of the muttaqeen. Now what are the characteristics of these individuals? How can we become amongst them? How do we know if the month of Ramadan, everything that we just did, we have attained taqwa, which is what the purpose of siyam was? How can we give ourselves a grade? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the muttaqeen. He says, الَّذِينَ يَنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. The ones that give in good times and in difficult times. So ask yourself, did you invest with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this Ramadan? Did you give for His sake in this month? The benefit of your fasting is that it brings you closer to God, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allows you to have that God consciousness. Did you see that in your actions? Did you give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And the next thing, he says, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظِ. Did you control your anger? While you are fasting, you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. You have stopped yourself from what is halal, eating and drinking. Have you stopped yourself from getting angry? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, مَنْ كَفَى غَضَبُهُ كَفَى اللَّهُ عَنْهُ عَذَابَهُ. Whoever controls their anger, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will alleviate them from the hellfire. So ask yourself, has my anger gotten better? Am I less angry? Have I attained that level of muttaqeen? And Allah continues, وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. And the ones that forgive others. Have you forgiven your family? That parent or that brother that you haven't spoken to for years, have you forgiven them and started talking to them? So that you can become amongst the muttaqeen. What good is your fasting if it doesn't allow you to attain taqwa? So strive for that taqwa. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concludes by saying, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those that are excellent. Now there is glad tidings for us all. There is still time for us to attain this taqwa. There is still time for us to be amongst the muttaqeen. We have to strive in the next few days, in the next few nights, to attain that level of taqwa that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants for us. But what are we going to do? How are we going to start? How are we going to start? First and foremost, just like we began the month of Ramadan with our intentions, we must begin with our intentions. Don't allow yourself to leave this masjid today without making the intention that you are going to strive for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the remainder of the month. And you will take advantage of every moment that you have. Secondly, those who fail to plan to fail. So you are going to make a plan with yourself. How am I going to strive? What am I going to do? If I haven't spent time with Quran, how will I spend time with Quran? If I haven't stayed up and prayed even 2 rak'at, how will I give myself time to pray 2 rak'at? If I haven't come to the masjid, what will I do to come to the masjid? Make a plan for yourself and hold yourself accountable. Every night before you sleep, hasib nafsak. Hold yourself accountable. How did I do today? Only have 4 days left in Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of our Ramadans. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. We spoke about what happens when we die. That our wealth and our family leave us. And the only thing that stays back is our actions. The only thing that follows us is our actions. And we have to strive together to work in bettering our actions so that we can attain the Jannah that we so strive for in this dunya and the akhirah. And I gave some advice on how we can start in the last 4 nights. And I want to continue with that advice. I want to make sure that we hold ourselves accountable and we have the intention to do well. But what actions, what amal can we begin with today to attain that level of muttaqin? The first is a hadith that talks about what happens even after we die. Because as we know, we are limited in our lives. But our actions can outlive us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, إِذَا مَاتُ ابْنُ آدَمْ إِنْقَطَى عَمَلَهُ إِلَّا عَنْ ثَلَاثٍ صَدَقَةٌ جَارِيَةٌ أَوْ عِلْمٌ يَنْتَفَعُ بِهِ أَوْ وَلَدٌ صَالِحٌ يَدْعُو لَهُ. So invest in the things that will continue after you die first. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if the son of Adam passes away, all of his actions stop except 3. The first action is sadaqatun jariya, an ongoing charity. So right now, before you leave, as you are going home, make the intention for ongoing charity and donate for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's not about donating a lot. It's about donating with the right intention. Number 2, ilmun yantafa'u bih. Alhamdulillah, I see many youth with us today, many children with us today. Don't allow your children to grow up without teaching them something from the Quran. Let that be the ilm that you give them that they pass on, so that you are rewarded even after you have passed. And thirdly, waladun salihun yad'u lah. Treat your children well and raise them well, so that they make dua for you in your old age and when you pass. And for those of us that are older, make dua for your parents. Be that waladun salih that you want your children to be by making dua to your parents. Number 2, Umm Aisha was sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he taught her something. He says, Ya Aisha, if it is Laylatul Qadr and you have yaqeen it's Laylatul Qadr, quli, say, اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا. Oh, Umm Aisha, if you know that it's Laylatul Qadr, and there's still 2 chances, it could be today and it could be on the 29th night, that it could be Laylatul Qadr, make the dua every night. It takes 1 minute. اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا. Oh Allah, you are the pardoner. You love to pardon. Pardon us. Because if He pardons you, what else matters? Alhamdulillah, you're pardoned. Pardon from everything that you have done. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us that pardon. Number 3, remember that Quran and dhikr don't finish after the 27th night. Ramadan continues until Tuesday at Asr. So continue to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until Tuesday at Asr. And after Tuesday at Asr, many of us have a misunderstanding that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of Ramadan is different than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of Shawwal. The same Rabb. The same Rabb. So if you're coming to the masjid, strive to come to the masjid after Ramadan. You come to the masjid every night, come twice a week. Strive with yourself that your actions continue. Show the results of Ramadan on your actions after Ramadan. Let the benefits of the fasting and the qiyam and the siyam represent a change in your life. Don't let your life after Ramadan be the same that your life was before Ramadan. And lastly, the advice that I give every time, and the last advice I like to end all my khutbah with, as-salah. In this month, Sahul Quran. But what khair is everything that we're doing if our relationship with salah is bad? What is the benefit of all of our actions of our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is bad? So remember your salah. Strive for your salah. Make sure that your five salawat at the very minimum are prayed on time every single day. And let that be your jihad. Let that be your struggle throughout your life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the strength to fulfill our prayers and to fulfill all of our actions. Allahumma hadina fi man hadayt, wa afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallayt. Allahumma hadina wa hdi bina wa ja'alna sababan liman ihtada. Allahumma hadina wa hdi bina wa ja'alna sababan liman ihtada. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واستغفروه يغفر لكم وأقم الصلاة.